plunge on the attack, even if it was painful and that sometimes we were receiving a punch. And again, katas and katas and katas. Pushing you to the maximum, until at one point you couldn't sweat anymore, and your tongue was becoming very thick in your mouth. And then when you could go drinking at the end of the workshop, you started to sweat again because you were completely dry, pushing you to the almost limit of your body, and starting again next day without stopping. We have the work that we practice very often in this school of Midare, which is a way of dodging opponents when you have 1, 2, 3, or even 10 around you. This work is indeed very intense. Half a second late and you have 10 punches on your belt from everywhere at the same time. Katas and katas again, never stopping, all the time working. Never any time to rest. Perfect movements were always asked by the master. Here you still have the work of Midare with just one partner, where you have to plunge on the attack of the other one, to take the initiative, to control, to dance with the other one who wants to kill you. We have the work of Midare, as I said before, based on the art of dodging, with the attack of 10 people at the same time making a big circle around you, and you must find the way out. So when you look at it like this, it looks a bit chaotic, but your spirit must fill the hole in the circle. The first one who is attacking is opening a little door where you could dodge and go out of the circle and push the one who attacked in the center. And when everybody is attacking, they are attacking on the one who was part of the circle, and you are outside of the circle. It's an utmost exercise of concentration, trust in your abilities, timing, and courage, because if you are wrong, it's extremely, extremely painful. If you were caught in the center, you could stay on the floor.